The bad news is nothing lasts forever. The good news is nothing lasts forever. Has anyone in this audience heard about PFAS? They are human-made chemicals which are strongly bound together. Because of their unique water and oil-proof properties, they have been used in lots of applications. Basically, they have found everywhere. Have you ever noticed pizza boxes and disposable paper cups, even food packaging, keep their shape even with hot stuff in them? How nonstick pans work fine without oil? Or how raincoats keep us dry? All these contain PFAS. So PFAS can enter our body when we eat, when we drink, even when we breathe. So why do we care? Of course, they can harm our health. So they can cause cancer, increase your cholesterol level, and reduce the vaccine responses, even for COVID vaccines. PFAS also found in breast milk. Imagine mothers passing PFAS into their babies. So part of my research investigates to what extent we are contaminated with PFAS. I do this with blood testing, and 95% of all the blood samples I tested contain PFAS. In other words, everyone here in this room might have PFAS in your body. This is very alarming. So the problem with PFAS is they don't break down in the environment or in our body. That's why we call them forever chemicals. But don't worry, I have the solution. We found a bacteria who can destroy these toxic PFAS. In other words, imagine a bustling kitchen, but instead of Gordon Ramsay, I'm the head chef with a new challenge on the menu, PFAS. But wait, I'm not alone. I have a team of little chefs, our bacteria buddies, who's ready to roll up their sleeves and chop up these toxic PFAS nearly 100% into smaller pieces. They only need a few days. So that means you cannot call them forever chemicals anymore. So my goal is to turn these toxic PFAS into smaller compounds like water. So my discovery holds the key to wiping out these PFAS from the world. So remember, nothing lasts forever. Thank you.